Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to this meeting on e-teachers kit. You know, before I really come on to what actually this teachers kit is and how it is going to help India, let me go to the background. And the background is that all these things are ultimately linked to e-learning. And what is e-learning? E-learning is related to technology-enabled learning. So in one sentence, one can see that we are doing, or what we are witnessing, is the wonders of technology in education. Technology has always been an enabler. It has helped us to achieve so many things. You know, it has made our life so convenient. Then why not education also? If you look at the various fields these days, banking, medicine, travel, tourism, in all the fields, technology has made a big impact and life is much more convenient. But in the context of education, in India, unfortunately, technology has not made that inroads so far. So e-learning is basically electronic learning. That means the focus is still on learning. E is just a mechanism. So you can say that e-learning is the learning which one achieves through information and communication technology. And ICT has already done wonders. What is ICT? ICT, you know, include all those technologies which make us, which get us access to information. Now, if e-learning is to be successful in any country, there are 3-4 things which one requires. One is, you know, infrastructure and, you know, internet connection, etc. This is the first prerequisite. Because without that, you cannot have e-learning on such a massive scale. Second is, you need a good content from where to learn. Of course, if you do Google search and look for anything, you will get so much content. But that content is not in a very structured manner. So you need a high quality structured content and perhaps also multimedia enriched and interactive also. What we get through Google, etc., is not that interactive. So this is the second thing. And the third thing is, we need teachers who are ICT savvy. So, you know, if we have these three prerequisites, good infrastructure, good connectivity, then good content, and then ICT savvy teachers, then, you know, this whole can change the face of education in the country. So one has to view everything from that perspective. Now, giving infrastructure and connectivity, that's not in our hands. But government said, and it felt, that, okay, we will give infrastructure and connectivity. That's, of course, the Digital India initiative of the government of India. But then we need to develop good content also. So that is how, a few years back, all these programs started. And the focus was ultimately to develop really high quality, multimedia enriched and interactive content. Fortunately for Khalsa College and for our Center for E-Learning, we got the project of developing content for postgraduate subjects. So we have developed content for 6 subjects. And there were about 70 to 80 subjects, almost all those subjects which are in the list of NET examination. So the government wanted the content to be developed in all of them. And so different other institutions were allotted different subjects. But luckily, you know, and I think we can say with a matter of great pride that in the entire country, our Center for E-Learning has been the front runner in the sense that we have developed the most, you know, sought after content. It's very much in demand. We have not only developed content, we have also converted that content into MOOCs. Because first you develop content, and then you arrange them in the form of a semester paper, which is spread over 15 weeks, and that is what we call a MOOC, Massive Open Online Course. So you can see that each MOOC is basically a one semester paper. So that has also been developed by us. And I think we at this Center for E-Learning are the people, we have developed the maximum number of MOOCs in the country at PG level. But then, you know, MOOCs have been developed, content is available, and very soon these will be available to the students across the country. And you know, these have been developed by the top experts of the country who had a vast experience. They are sharing through these MOOCs and through these each content. And now you can very well imagine that how will it help India? It will help India in the sense that anybody in the country can enroll in these MOOCs, learn from them, and then appear in an examination. So even if you don't have a university or a college near your city, or you may be sitting in the remotest part of the country, you can still have an opportunity to enroll in any MOOC and learn on your own. And you know, the basic philosophy of the MOOCs is 4 A's: anytime, anyone, anywhere, any number of times. You learn the content anytime. So it is going to be a big boon for all those lifelong learners. You know, I am a man of chemistry, but if I want to learn from a MOOC of economics, nobody can stop me. So that is bringing about a big change. You know, there were many people who are lifelong learners. They want to learn so many things. But then some people are very aged. They don't want to go to universities or colleges. So through internet and all that, they can learn. So it has brought about a revolution, you know, sort of thing. So this is one aspect which we have been doing. Then as Dr. Vimal and Dr. Jaswinder Singh pointed out, and as I also said, the third aspect is that we need to empower teachers. Because once these MOOCs are offered, who will monitor the problems of the learners? If they have some question, they will ask, who will answer those queries? So all those problems ultimately need to be answered by we teachers. So don't think that this entire process is going to replace teacher. Nobody can replace teacher. Only thing is, the role of the teachers is going to change. Earlier, we were delivering lectures in the classroom through talk and chalk method. Now we will be helping the learners through MOOCs, through, you know, various group discussions, through solving their queries. So all that work is going. And in this regard, we need teachers who are ICT savvy. So this Center for E-Learning is producing content, but this Guru Angad Dev Teaching Learning Center, which is a center of the MHRD, this is focusing on this aspect of e-learning. Okay, prepare modern age teachers. Prepare them so that they can help in the implementation and execution of the MOOCs. So therefore, their role is also becoming very, very important. We have conducted various workshops and all that we are doing. And basically, I think I can say that slowly, undercurrent, a silent revolution is going on in the country on all these three fronts. And believe you me, after 5 or 10 years, the entire face of education is going to change. Education will no longer remain limited to the classrooms. It will be available on your mobile. You can just enroll to any MOOC and learn while sitting even in the metro or in the train or in the car. So things are now going to change. So looking at all those aspects, now you may be thinking that then why do we need teacher's kit? Because this meeting is specially for that. You know, we need teacher's kit. This is of a slightly higher level. MOOCs which we have developed, they are primarily for the students. If I am an MSc chemistry student, I have passed my BSc, or if you are MA economics student, then MOOCs of economics are helpful to you. But then we thought that we should also develop some learning material for the teachers. Teachers are at a higher level. No doubt even that material will be useful for the teachers as well if they want to learn, because you can learn from any, because all this content has been written by top experts. There is always something to learn from MOOCs also. But this idea which has come from Guru Angad Dev Teaching Learning Center and which has been accepted by the MHRD, this will basically focus on developing, you can say, content for teachers. So it has to be of higher level. Just as MOOCs have been developed according to the four quadrant approach, similarly, on parallel lines, we have going to develop teacher's kit material. There will be a text. For every paper, just as we developed a MOOC, similarly, for every paper, there will be four quadrants. You know, it's like this, that if one paper is of, say, 35 or 40 hours, we divide it into 35 modules, syllabus-wise, and then for each module, we will be developing teacher's kit for the help of the teachers. Because teachers should have a much greater expertise. So teacher can deliver better in their classes. The focus should not be on rote learning. The focus should be on nurturing thinking, innovation, and creativity amongst our students. So therefore, developing teacher's kit is going to be a very big challenge. You have to write the material which will help teachers in providing guidance to the students. So it is going to be a big challenge. Therefore, as I'm sure Dr. Vimal and Professor Bhanumurthy, they will talk in details about all this. Whatsoever papers are allotted to you for developing e-teacher's kit, take all those papers where you can really do justice. Justice in the sense where you can provide material which can help young new teachers in preparing for their classes and maybe later on in developing content also. So, you know, every teacher has some expertise. There are some fields where you have done a lot of thinking and you think that you are very good in this. Then you should try to develop content using your that expertise. It's not going to be that easy, but it's a big challenge. And then, you know, once your teacher's kit become popular, you become so famous. Everybody will say, oh, I want to have his or her kit. So this can really do wonders. So take a lot of pains, think a lot. It should not be just that writing and writing. Each line should convey something so that the teachers understand, and then those teachers can help the students learn the subject. Because these are today, I think, primarily for commerce and economics teachers. You know, logical reasoning you can convey to them. Data interpretation is very important, which we should tell our students how to do that. Analytical skills are very important. Sometimes we don't tell the students. You know, our students are good sometimes on rote learning, not in these skills. I think digital literacy includes all those things. So content development should focus on all those things. So I will not go into the details because there are special presentations by our colleagues. They will focus on that. But ultimately, please remember, the success of any e-content material, whether it is the material for the students or for the teachers or for anything, ultimately it will depend upon its quality. Quality should not be compromised. Therefore, anybody or everybody cannot write content for any paper. No, it's not possible. You have to share your expertise. So I think this is going to be very important. And I'm very happy that many of you have come here today, shown interest in that, And once the details are shared with you, I'm sure you will certainly like to be involved in this. And then, as I think Dr. Jaswinder Singh also said, besides making you famous, I will put it the word famous. You know, there are many MOOCs and e-content in the world. Those authors have become worldwide famous because of their MOOCs. They have become worldwide famous. And so much enrollment in millions for certain courses. Why? Just because it is the quality which is reflected in the content which they make. So take it as a challenge. And of course, second thing is you get also API score. That is also a part of that. That is additional incentive for you people. So you work, you become famous, you share your expertise with others, you get API score, then everybody talks about you. What else you need? What else you need? I think we also think on those lines. These are very important. Otherwise, you know what will happen? You may be a very good teacher. Your influence will be only limited to your classroom only, or to 50, 100 teachers whom you teach. But through this, you can go to the entire country and even to the entire world. Anybody can enroll in these courses. So my best wishes to all of you, and I'm sure you try to see the reason behind why we are doing this. So this is also empowerment of the teachers, but this is empowerment of the teachers in their own domains. That's what you are trying to help us. So try to see from that perspective, and I think not only you, we also have a great deal to learn from your experience. Because I personally feel good ideas can come from any person. Age doesn't come in the way. So you should share your expertise, your ideas with us, and try to help and give benefit to the entire teaching community and make the success of Digital India Initiative. Thank you very much, and my best wishes to all of you. Thank you.